Hello, hello, everyone. Hello, my wonderful, precious, beautiful people of the Most High God. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. How are we all doing today, guys? I am bringing you greetings, and it's in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Let the peace of my Father, the peace that surpasses all human understanding, be your portion and my portion. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. To all my returning amazing subscribers, you guys are simply the best. What could I have done without you? Without you, there is no us, and that is the truth. So thank you guys for watching us. Thank you for your comments, likes, shares. Thank you for everything that you do for this channel. And to everyone that has not subscribed to this channel, what are you waiting for? If you do come across us on this YouTube street, can you please hit the red subscription button and the notification bell so you get notified when we do upload new videos? I am Juliana of this Juliana TV. In this my channel, we talk about God, we talk about love, life, relationship, charity, and all health related matters. So guys, hop on board and let's do this together. Happy Sunday, everyone. Today is Sunday, and it brings us to the beginning of a new week. What a privilege it is to see another week today. We are blessed in the name of the God Almighty for making it possible to be in another week. We are thanking the creator of the universe that he made it possible for us to see today. It is not by our might, it is not by our strength, but it is by his mercy, it is by his kindness, because by strength shall no man prevail, according to the word of God in the book of 1 Samuel 2:9. So in this week, guys, our reading comes from the Acts of the Apostles 17:30 that says, "The days of ignorance the Lord will overlook." And Deuteronomy 5:9 says, "I, the Lord thy God, I am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children up to the third and fourth generation of them that hate me." Child of God, the word of God is very clear that the iniquities of the fathers will be visited upon the children up to the third and to the fourth generation. Some of us are actually suffering the consequences of the things that were done by our ancestors, the things that were done in the years and years and years past that we know nothing about, child of God. But in this week, we are begging the Father to have a mercy. We are petitioning the throne of grace, and we are reminding the Father of heaven, as of the Apostles 17:30, that says that the days of ignorance is what he will overlook. We're asking him to have a mercy on us, that the consequences of the things that were committed by our fathers and our ancestors past, that we know nothing about, that we will stop suffering from them, that whatever they have levied and brought against us by their acts and their actions, by the covenants, by the oaths, whatever they did in those days that is still chasing us around. Listen, there are things that happen in families. When they become repetitive, we know that this becomes a family occurrence. In some families, it's high blood pressure, diabetes, cancer, all kinds of stuff that happens in the families. People don't live long enough to reap the fruit of their labor. And so, child of God, when we see all these negative occurrences happening in our families, we know they are not ordinary. And that is why we are gathering together today as the children of the Most High God to plead for mercy from the throne of God, from the throne of mercy, to ask the Lord to look down on us with pity, that a humble contrite heart he will not despise, that his word for us will be through. Acts of the Apostles 17:30, that the days of ignorance is what he will forgive. We are asking him to forgive our fathers, that he will not visit the sins upon us, to forgive our ancestors, our fathers, that those things they did, some of them were done out of ignorance. So out of the reason, by the reason of his word, that the days of ignorance will be ignored, that he will ignore and forgive those things, those sins, and give us a second chance. That he says that if we should confess our sins, that it will be thrown into the sea of non-remembrance, that he will forgive our sins, that they will be thrown into the sea of non-remembrance, and these things will not come against us anymore. And so we stand upon his word as we revoke, as we denounce, as we separate ourselves from whatsoever our fathers did, our forefathers, whatsoever they did that is coming back to be a pain upon our lives now. We separate, we reject, and we revoke them, because we did not know what they did. They did it out of ignorance, and we ourselves were paying for the price of the things that we did not know either. So we are asking the Lord to please have a mercy, and even for the things that we did as human beings, that we did out of ignorance too, out of the weakness of our body as humans, that the Father will have mercy, that he will forgive us, that he will cleanse us, that he will let these things go, that it will disappear from his face by the reason of him being our God, by him saying that he will forgive, that this will be true for me and for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So let this week be a week of mercy, pleading the throne of mercy for forgiveness. That is what this week is all about, that things will turn around good for us, that our destiny will rise and shine, that we will never be suppressed forever anymore. In the mighty name of Jesus, let there be a total turnaround for us, even as this week will come to an end, even as this month will come to an end, even as this year will come to an end. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. So child of God, love God, serve God, bless humanity, faith, hope, and love. The greatest of them all is love, for love covers a multitude of sin. I cannot say I love God, but I don't care for others. That is fake love. So live the life Christ lived on earth, a life of love, a life of giving, a life of caring. And the one that has commissioned us to do so will bless us for doing that. Because if you obey his commandments, if you follow his precepts and his principles, child of God, there's always a blessing attached for obedience. So he himself will do mighty things in our lives as we go forth to follow his footsteps in this week, in this month, and in the years to come. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. We are in the season of giving, giving thanks, giving to others. Find a way to make yourself to give. Find a way to give those things you don't need, the things that you have extra that you can share with others. Find a way to make that happen, child of God. And the Father of heaven will forever bless you. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. I am Juliana of this Juliana TV. Remember, love God, serve God, bless humanity. Remember, faith, hope, and love, the greatest of them all is love. And I make well to say, I love you. Thank you for your support. I am appreciative of you. God will surely bless you both now and forever. In the name of Jesus, amen. Juliana, I am signing out right this very moment. And I will see you at my next upload. Remain pretty, stay protected under the cover of his wings. And may my Father bless you both now and forever. In the name of Jesus, whatsoever you do to the least of my brothers, he says, he will do it for you, child of God. Remain blessed and remain protected. See you next time. God bless you. Love you. Bye-bye. Can you have a